हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इंटीग्रल्स, चैप्टर 7 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी क्लास 12th पार्ट सेकंड बुक। इंटीग्रल्स आर आल्सो कॉल्ड एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स, मींस इंटीग्रल इज इनवर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन। यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड डिफरेंशिएशन, सो वी विल यूज all the differentiation formula to find out the formulas for integration. Whatever required will be derived from the formulas of differentiation only. Okay, so this integration is also called antiderivative. Now you have already done differentiation very well, so I am using all the differential formula. And with the help of those formulas, we will derive integration formula. So d upon dx of x to the power n, this formula you know that it is equal to n x to the power n minus 1. Now we will put at the place of n, n plus 1. So what will be d upon dx of x to the power n plus 1 is equal to, instead of n, n plus 1 will come, and here where n is there, we will write n plus 1. So n plus 1 minus 1, we will have x to the power n. Now, this n plus 1 we cross multiply. So d upon dx of x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 is equal to x to the power n. Means when we differentiate x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1, we have x to the power n. In other words, we can say when we find out integral of x to the power n, we will have this function x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. One more fact you know from differentiation, that when you differentiate any constant with respect to x, you will get 0. This is very important concept, that differentiation of constant is 0, means integration of 0 is constant. So here you have, I have told you, d upon dx of x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 is equal to x to the power n. It means when we integrate x to the power n, we will have this function. But we will write integral x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus constant. We can write constant as, if we differentiate the right hand side, we must have the left hand side. Now we differentiate this. So d upon dx of this x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 with this formula, it will be x to the power n, and d upon dx of this constant will be 0. So what you will have? You will have x to the power n only when you differentiate the right hand side. So this is the formula in integration. Each formula we can write plus c. But this formula is not applicable for n is equal to minus 1. See, we put in this formula n is equal to minus 1. So as we put x to the power minus 1 dx, the right hand side will be x to the power 0 upon 0. Means x to the power 0 upon 0 is a quantity which cannot be defined. So this formula is not applicable for n is equal to minus 1. This you must keep in mind. So for finding the formula integral of x to the power minus 1 dx, we know from differentiation d upon dx of log mod x is equal to 1 by x. So 1 by x ka jab hum integration karenge, what we will have? Log mod x. So integral of x to the power minus 1 dx is equal to log mod x plus c. Plus c to we can write in each and every formula. Now d upon dx of sin x. D upon dx of sin x is equal to cos x. So integral of cos x is equal to sin x plus c. The formula here I have written, I make a box on that. So you have to learn whatever I have made boxes for those formulas. D upon dx of cos x is equal to minus sin x. Now we will multiply the equation with minus sign. So what it will, d upon dx of minus cos x is equal to sin x. So when we integrate sin x, we will have minus cos x plus c. So integral of sin x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c. डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ टेन एक्स, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ टेन एक्स इज इक्वल टू सेक्स स्क्वेयर एक्स, सो इंटीग्रल सेक्स स्क्वेयर एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू टेन एक्स प्लस सी. अनदर फॉर्मूला, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ कॉट एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस कोसेक्स स्क्वेयर एक्स, सिंस हियर माइनस साइन सो अगेन वी विल मल्टीप्लाई द इक्वेशन विथ माइनस साइन, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ माइनस कॉट एक्स इज इक्वल टू यहाँ प्लस हो जाएगा कोसेक्स स्क्वेयर एक्स. सो वेन वी इंटीग्रेट कोसेक्स स्क्वेयर एक्स विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू डी एक्स, इंटीग्रल कोसेक्स स्क्वेयर एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस कॉट एक्स प्लस सी. नेक्स्ट, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ सेक एक्स इज इक्वल टू सेक एक्स टेन एक्स, सो इंटीग्रल ऑफ सेक एक्स टेन एक्स इज इक्वल टू सेक एक्स प्लस सी. डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ साइन इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन अंडर रूट वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर, मीन्स इंटीग्रल ऑफ वन अपॉन अंडर रूट वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू साइन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी. अगेन, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ कॉस इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन अपॉन अंडर रूट वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर, डी वी विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस बोथ द साइड्स विथ माइनस साइन, सो डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ माइनस कॉस इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन अंडर रूट वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर, सो इंटीग्रल ऑफ वन अपॉन अंडर रूट वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर इज डी एक्स, एंड इन द प्रीवियस फार्मूला वी हैव सीन द सेम क्वांटिटी इज इक्वल टू साइन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी. सो हियर वन अपॉन अंडर रूट वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस कॉस इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी एज वेल एज इज इक्वल टू साइन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी. अगेन, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ टेन इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वेयर, सो इंटीग्रल वन अपॉन वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू टेन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी. डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ कॉट इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन अपॉन वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वेयर, वेयर एवर द माइनस साइन इज देयर वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई बोथ द साइड्स विथ माइनस साइन, एंड देन वी विल हैव द फॉर्मूला इंटीग्रल वन अपॉन वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वेयर डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस कॉट इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी, एंड इन दिस प्रीवियस वन वी हैव सीन द सेम फार्मूला फॉर टेन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी, सो वी कैन राइट ओवर हियर डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ सेक इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन एक्स अंडर रूट एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस वन, सो इंटीग्रल ऑफ डी एक्स अपॉन एक्स अंडर रूट एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू सेक इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी. डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ कोसेक इनवर्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन अपॉन एक्स अंडर रूट एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस वन मल्टीप्लाइंग विथ माइनस साइन, यू विल हैव इंटीग्रल ऑफ वन अपॉन एक्स अंडर रूट एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस वन डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस कोसेक इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी, एंड द सेम थिंग इज इक्वल टू सेक इनवर्स एक्स प्लस सी फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस फार्मूला. नाउ डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ ई टू द पावर एक्स इज इक्वल टू ई टू द पावर एक्स, सो इंटीग्रल ऑफ ई टू द पावर एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू ई टू द पावर एक्स प्लस सी. नेक्स्ट फार्मूला, डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ ए टू द पावर एक्स इज इक्वल टू लॉग ए इंटू ए टू द पावर एक्स. हियर इन दिस फार्मूला ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट एंड एक्स इज वेरिएबल एंड वी आर डिफरेंशिएटिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स, सो दिस लॉग ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट वी विल क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई इट, सो डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ ए टू द पावर एक्स अपॉन लॉग ए इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर एक्स, सो इंटीग्रल ऑफ ए टू द पावर एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर एक्स अपॉन लॉग ए प्लस सी. नाउ वॉट यू हैव टू डू अ लिटिल बिट एक्सरसाइज टू नोट डाउन ऑल द फार्मूलाज ऑन वन पेज एंड मेक अ चार्ट एंड स्टिक दैट चार्ट इन योर स्टडी रूम एंड एवरी डे लर्न all those formula in 4-5 days you will learn them by heart. Now we are going to solve exercise number 7.1 on page number 299. Question number 1, find an antiderivative or integral of sin 2x. Now what is the meaning of antiderivative? Antiderivative means integral, and they have told you to find out by the method of inspection. By the method of inspection means we will find a function whose differentiation is equal to sine 2x. So as differentiation and integral are inverse of each other, so we can write that integral of sine 2x is the differentiation of the given function. Are you getting me? No. Now we are solving exercise number 7.1. Question number 1. We have to find antiderivative of sine 2x by the method of inspection. By the method of inspection means with the help of this method you will find that one function whose differentiation is equal to sine 2x. So now we will find differentiation of cos 2x. Differentiation of cos 2x is equal to what it will be? You will apply the formula d upon dx of cos x is equal to minus sin x. So cos 2x is there, so its differentiation will be minus sin 2x, and you will again have to differentiate the 2x, that will be equal to 2. So the resultant will be minus 2 sin 2x. Now you have to find antiderivative of sin 2x, so just keep sin 2x over here. Minus 2 you bring it to cross multiply it. So what it will be? D upon dx of minus 1 by 2 cos 2x is equal to sin 2x. Means when we differentiate this function, minus 1 by 2 cos 2x, we have sin 2x. So in other way we can say the antiderivative of sin 2x is equal to minus 1 by 2 cos 2x. So antiderivative of sin 2x is minus 1 by 2 cos 2x. Now in question number 2, we will find out antiderivative of cos 3x. Again we are in search of a function whose differentiation should be equal to cos 3x. Now we differentiate function sin 3x. Sin 3x, so sin 3x ka differentiation kya ho jayega? D upon dx of sin x is equal to cos x. So d upon dx of sin 3x is equal to cos 3x into d upon dx of 3x, that will be equal to 3. So we will cross multiply these three. So d upon dx of 1 by 3 sin 3x is equal to cos 3x. So antiderivative of cos 3x is 1 by 3 sin 3x. Question number 3. Find antiderivative of e to the power 2x. Now you know, you will use here formula that d upon dx of e to the power x is equal to e to the power x. So d upon dx of e to the power 2x is equal to e to the power 2x into d upon dx of 2x, which is equal to 2. So cross multiply 2, d upon dx of 1 by 2 e to the power 2x is equal to e to the power 2x. So antiderivative of e to the power 2x is equal to 1 by 2 e to the power 2x. Now question number 4. Question number 4. You have to find out antiderivative of ax plus b square. Now here you will use the formula d upon dx of x to the power n is equal to n x to the power n minus 1. So you know that when we differentiate, then one power is reduced. So what we will do here is power 2. So we will differentiate d upon dx of ax plus b to the power 3. So it will reduce and the 2 will come. So apply the formula. What will be the differentiation? 3 ax plus b whole square into d upon dx of ax plus b, which will be equal to a. Cross multiply it, d upon dx of 1 upon 3a ax plus b cube is equal to ax plus b whole square. So what is antiderivative of ax plus b square? 1 by 3a ax plus b cube. Question number 5. Find antiderivative of sin 2x minus 4 e to the power 3x. Now antiderivative of sin 2x you have already done in question number 1. So from there straight away we will write. But for finding antiderivative of 4 e to the power 3x, we will differentiate e to the power 3x. D upon dx of e to the power 3x is equal to e to the power 3x into d upon dx of 3x, which will be equal to 3. Now multiply the equation with minus 4 from both the sides. is here we need minus 4, that's why we are multiplying with minus 4. So minus 4 will be multiplied with both the sides. Okay, so minus 4 d upon dx of minus 4 into e to the power 3x is equal to minus 4 e to the power 3x into 3. But here you have to find out antiderivative of only minus 4 e to the power 3x. So one excess 3 is over here, so we will cross multiply it. So d upon dx of minus 4 upon 3 e to the power 3x is equal to minus 4 e to the power 3x. So antiderivative of minus 4 e to the power 3x is minus 4 upon 3 e to the power 3x. And from question number 1, you can write antiderivative of sine 2x is, antiderivative of sine 2x is what? Minus 1 by 2 cos 2x. And here just we have seen the antiderivative of minus 4 e to the power 3x is minus 4 by 3 e to the power 3x. So you have done 5 questions. Now from 6th questions, they are asking us to find out the integrals from 6 to 20. So question number 6. In question number 6, you have to find out integral of 4 e to the power 3x plus 1. dx. Now this is the plus sign is there, so two terms are there, so we will separate it. We will have two integrals, 4 e to the power 3x dx plus 1 dx. Now what is antiderivative of 4 e to the power 3x? This you have done in question number 5, but there was minus sign, so you don't take that minus sign. Directly you can write 4 by 3 e to the power 3x. And 1 dx is equal to 1 means x to the power 0. X to the power 0. So which formula you will apply? Integral x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So x to the power 0 means integral x to the power 0 dx is equal to x to the power 0 plus 1 upon 0 plus 1. What it will be? X only. So 4 by 3 e to the power 3x plus x plus c. Here is question number 7. Integral of x square bracket 1 minus 1 upon x square dx. Multiply with x square, you will have integral of x square minus 1 dx. Now integral of x square is equal to x to the power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1. That will be x cube upon 3. And minus 1, that we have just now seen in the previous question, that is equal to minus x plus c. Now question number 8 and 9, they are very easy questions, but still I have solved them and I have given the link in the description box. I have posted pics of those questions, you can see from there and solve them. Now jump to the question number 10. Question number 10 is integral bracket under root x minus 1 upon root x whole square dx. Now apply the formula a minus b whole square over here. This is the formula you will apply. You will have root x square means x plus 1 upon root x square means 1 by x minus 2ab means minus 2 dx. Now here three terms are there. So you have to separate it, means you have to write down formula for three integrals. So integral of x will be x to the power 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1. That will be x square by 2. Integral of 1 by x is log mod x, and minus 2, integral of minus 2 dx is equal to minus 2x plus c. Question number 11. Question number 11 is integral of x cube plus 5x square minus 4 upon x square dx. Now we will separate x square, means we will write x square to the denominator of each term, means x cube upon x square plus 5x square upon x square minus 4 upon x square. So what will be? X cube upon x square is x, 5x square upon x square is plus 5 minus 4 upon x square means minus 4x to the power minus 2 dx. Now in this again you apply the formula integral of x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1, and you will have x square upon 2 plus 5x minus 4 x to the power minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1 plus c. Plus c is compulsory in each question, you have to write plus c. If you are not going to write, you are going to lose the marks. So x square by 2 plus 5x, this here it will come minus 1, so the sign will change, plus 4x to the power minus 1 plus c. Now question number 12, integral of x cube plus 3x plus 4 upon root x dx. Again we will separate under root x and we will write denominator to each term. Here we have written x cube upon root x plus 3x upon root x, means which is resultant root x only, plus 4 upon root x dx. Again now we will write in power. So x to the power 3 minus 1 by 2 plus 3x to the power 1 by 2, as root x we can write x to the power 1 by 2, and this root x we will write in numerator x to the power minus 1 by 2. Now differentiate this. When you differentiate this, when you integrate this, what you now you will solve this equation. You have x to the power 5 by 2 plus 3x to the power 1 by 2 plus 4x to the power minus 1 by 2 dx. Now integrate this with the help of the formula, integral x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So after applying the formula, you will get x to the power 5 by 2 plus 1 upon 5 by 2 plus 1 plus 3 x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 upon 1 by 2 plus 1 plus 4 x to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus c. Now you can easily solve that and you will have this equation, 2 by 7 x to the power 7 by 2 plus 2 x to the power 3 by 2 plus 8 x to the power 1 by 2 plus c. Now question number 13 is a little bit tricky. You please pay attention. X cube minus x square plus x minus 1 upon x minus 1 dx. Now what is in denominator? X minus 1. So here you have to pay attention, when we take x common from the first two term, sorry, x square common from first two term, what will be in the bracket remain? X minus 1. So we will rearrange this term like this. We will take out x square common, what is inside? X minus 1, and upon x minus 1 plus this x minus 1 is already there, and we will write this denominator over here. So we separate the terms. Now these two will cancel each other. Here also x minus 1 get cancelled. So what you will have? You will have integral of just x square is left here, and in this term 1. Integral of x square plus 1 dx. Now integrate this. This is x to the power 3 upon 3 plus x plus c. Now this question number 15th is similar to question number 12th. Question number 14, question number 16, 17, 18, you can solve them. They are easy. You can solve them by applying direct formula, but I have solved them and given their solution in the link below, so you can check there. But I am advising you first to solve them by yourself. If you are not getting answers, then only you check. Okay. Now we will jump to the question number 19. Question number 19 is integral sec square x upon cosec square x dx. So we will change it into sine and cos. So you know the formulas for this. In trigonometry, you have already studied the formula. So 1 upon cosec square x we can write. 1 upon cosec square x, instead of that we write sin square x, and sec square x is equal to 1 upon cos square x. So the term will integral sin square x upon cos square x dx. Now sin x upon cos x is 10x, so this is 10 square x, so integral 10 square x dx. But we don't know any formula in this form, integral 10 square x, but we know the formula integral sec square x. So that's why we will change this 10 square x into in the form of sec square x. So you know one more formula from trigonometry one plus 10 square x is equal to sec square x. So integral of sec square x means we can write 10 square x is sec square x minus 1. So here we will write. So here you have two terms. So integral of sec square x dx is 10x and minus 1 dx integral is x minus x plus c. Question number 20 is integral of 2 minus 3 sin x upon cos square x dx. Now again we separate the cos square x. So we will have 2 upon cos square x minus 3 into sin x upon cos square x. So 2 upon cos square x minus 3 into sin x upon cos x, we can write 10x, and 1 cos x is remaining in the denominator, and when it will go in numerator it will become sec x, because 1 upon cos x is equal to sec x. So the terms are 2 upon cos square x minus 3 into 10x into sec x. Now you must be thinking, why we are doing this? Because the formulas for integral we know, we should bring the terms in the form of those formulas, then only we can apply the formula, because we don't know the formula in this form. So now 2 upon cos square x is equal to 2 sec square x minus 3 10 x sec x dx. Now you know the formula for integral sec square x, integral 10 x sec x. So you will apply those formula. You can see in your chart prepared, integral 2 sec square x is equal to 2 10 x minus 3 is constant. So it will come like this, and integral of 10 x sec x is equal to sec x plus c. Now again for question number 21, you read the book. The question number 21 is multiple choice question. The antiderivative of root x plus 1 upon under root x equals 2. Means you have to find out the integral of root x plus 1 upon under root x. So we will find integral of root x plus 1 upon root x dx, and here we can apply the formula integral x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So here is power 1 by 2. So x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 upon 1 by 2 plus 1. In second term, the x to the power minus 1 by 2. So plus x to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus c. When you solve this, you will have 2 by 3 x to the power 3 by 2 plus 2 x to the power 1 by 2 plus c. So answer c is correct. Answer c is matching to your answer. Okay. Now we will do question number 22. Question number 22 says, if d upon dx of fx, any function fx, you differentiate it, you will get 4x cube minus 3 upon x to the power 4, such that f2 is equal to 0. This is given. F2 is equal to 0. Then, what will be the value of fx? Means you have to find out the function of x. The function is such that when we differentiate the function, you will have this function. It means when we integrate this function, we will have fx. So we'll find out the integration of this, and the integration of this, after finding the integration, we will have the function, and in that function at the place of x we will write 2, then we will have that equation is equal to 0. So okay, we will do, then you will get it. So integral of 4x cube minus 3 upon x to the power 4 dx, you will apply the formula. The 4 is constant, x cube, integral x cube dx is x to the power 4 upon 4, minus 3 again constant, x to the power minus 4 is here, so x to the power minus 4 plus 1 upon minus 4 plus 1 plus c. When you solve this, you will have fx is equal to x to the power 4 plus x to the power minus 3 plus c. Now in this equation, you will write x is equal to 2. Because you have given f2 is equal to 0. This is given. So in place of x, you will write 2. Here 2 to the power 4 plus 2 to the power minus 3 plus c. So एफ टू इज इक्वल टू जीरो, टू टू द पावर फोर इज 16, टू टू द पावर माइनस थ्री इज इक्वल टू वन बाय एट प्लस सी. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन यू कैन फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट. दैट कॉन्स्टेंट कम्स आफ्टर सॉल्विंग माइनस 129 अपॉन एट. नाउ पुट इन दिस इक्वेशन द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट. सो द एफ एक्स विल बी एक्स टू द पावर फोर प्लस एक्स टू द पावर माइनस थ्री प्लस माइनस 129 अपॉन एट, विच इज द ऑप्शन नंबर ए. सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द सोल्यूशन ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 7.1. आई होप यू मस्ट बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग वट एवर आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग. इफ यू लाइक देन प्लीज कमेंट मी एंड लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल. थैंक यू.